In this video, I'm going to show you how you can make a drone from scratch like this. In the previous video, I told you the components that you're going to need to make a drone. I explained you which component you should get according to your requirement and everything else. In this video, we are going to use that components to build this drone. So let's get started. Right now, I've got all the components that I'm going to need to make myself the drone. If you don't know which component you should get, then watch the previous video. The link is in the description box. So over here, I've got the power distribution board, the ESCs, the parts of the frame, motors, the transmitter and the receiver, the cross-like flight controller, GPS, and everything else. Start with the building process. The first step is to set up a power distribution board. It includes the connection of our ESC with the power distribution board. So this is the electronic speed controller or the ESC. The first step includes the cutting of this connector and then connecting it to the power distribution board. So I have already soldered the ESC to the power distribution board, but I am going to tell you exactly how you can do it. First, you need to cut these connectors and then place it. You need to solder it over here. Make sure the red wire is soldered to the plus terminal and the black wire is soldered to the negative terminal. These connectors will already come soldered and you have to do this with the four different ESCs. So let's attach the power distribution board and the ESCs to the frame now. Our frame consists of the lower plate, the upper plate. Right now I have added the flight controller to it, but I will tell you more about it later on. These four arms, as well as some optional landing gears. So first, let's attach the power distribution board to the lower plate. So you can use double sided tape or some other tape. Make sure it's in the middle, like this. Each ESC will go over here between these two holes and each arm will be placed over here like this. So now the lower plate is done setting up. So now let's connect these motors to our arm. So these are the four holes. We are going to match it with these. You can attach three screws to each motor. So just like this, we have attached the motor to the arm. So we are going to do the same for other three arms. So I have now attached each motor to each arm. So let's connect these arms to the top part. So this is the top part of the frame. So as you can see, I have already added something over here. So this is the flight controller. Between the frame and the flight controller, over here you can see I have added a shock absorber which comes with the flight controller. So this helps to cushion the vibrations while the drone is still flying. So again, this is the frame, shock absorber, then the flight controller. So now we are going to attach these arms to the frame. So we are going to put these like this and connect each of the arm like this. So let's start. attach the arm with the upper plate. So now we are going to join all of this with our lower plate. So make sure that these ESCs go in between these legs over here, and make sure it works out with all four of them. So let's connect it. The ESC will go between these two legs and will be placed like this. Just make sure everything is correct. And yes, now use the screws to attach it with the lower plate. If you have, you can also use these landing gears that you can attach over here. So now that our drone is structurally complete, we are going to do the connections for the electronics. First of all, we are going to connect the ESCs with the flight controller. Pay attention to this sign over here. This is going to mark the forward for your drone. So the right diagonal arm will be the first connection to the flight controller, and the opposite to the right diagonal arm will be the second one connected to the flight controller. The left diagonal arm will be the third one, and the opposite to it would be the fourth connection. Let me show it. So this, the right diagonal arm will be first connected over to here. The first one over here. The second, the opposite to the right diagonal arm will be connected next. The left diagonal arm will be connected next. And opposite to left diagonal arm, this one would be connected next. One important thing to note while connecting the wires of the ESC to the flight controller is that the yellow wire should be on the top. So these were the connections for your ESC. So now let's move on to the motors. So these brushless motors have the capability to move counterclockwise and clockwise. In a drone, the diagonal right and opposite to it should move in counterclock direction, and these two should move clockwise. So we are going to do the connections appropriately. So the yellow wire of the motor is connected with the middle wire of the ESC. And the other two wires can be connected in any way, because we'll check the direction of it while configuring the drone. Next, I'm using zip ties to fix the ESCs over the frame like this, so that they're not hanging in the air while the drone is flying. So all the ESCs are being fixed to the drone. Now we are going to connect the, we are going to power the flight controller from the power distribution board with the wire. So we will use this wire which came with the flight controller. So this part over here will be connected to the power distribution board and this one to the flight controller. Like this. And over here. Now we are going to connect the receiver. So first we are going to take some double tape. And place it over here. Take this wire which came with the flight controller. This end will be attached in the flight controller like this. This end will be connected to the receiver in the channel 1. The yellow wire will be on the top. Use double-sided tape to attach the buzzer to the drone. So now the receiver is connected with the flight controller. Now we are going to attach our battery to the drone. Next, let's attach each propeller to the motor. So if you look carefully over here, there's a number written on it. On mine, it's written 1045R. R will be used for clockwise motors. Diagonal left was clockwise. So this will be used for 1045R propeller. So to attach your propeller, first use this adapter which comes with the motors. Place it like this. Then use this, place your propeller, next this, and tighten up your propeller. You can use a Allen key to tighten it up. So this motor will also use a 1045R propeller and these two motors will use a 1045 propeller. So next let's add a GPS module. So this wire will plug over here in this. And then use a double side tape to attach it. There will be also arrow on your GPS module. So make sure it matches the arrow on your flight controller. So we have added our GPS.
Our drone is now ready.
All the connections are made as well as the frame is ready. In the next video, I'm going to show you how you can do the configuration and take a flight. We'll use the Mission Planner app to do the configuration and also add some external features. So I'll see you in the next video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Bye bye.